Hello kids, good morning. I hope you all are doing great and enjoying yourselves at home.
Let's start the day with thought for the day. Today's thought for the day is treat others the way you want to be treated. So kids, we should always treat everyone in a respectable manner so that they also treat us the same way.
I welcome you all in a new EVS class. Kids, do you remember which chapter are we doing? We are doing chapter number 3, Health is Wealth. And we had discussed a lot of things regarding our health. In this class, we shall do fill in the blanks. Now kids, you must be wondering, what do you mean by fill in the blanks? Kids, in fill in the blanks, we fill a blank with a correct word and then the sentence gives us a complete and correct meaning. Okay children? So, when I will give you examples, you all will understand. And all the fill in the blanks are related to our previous class in which I had told you everything related to the chapter which help us in keeping fit and clean. So kids, let us start today's class with fill in the blanks. Now kids, can you see the above line? What is it written? It is written that we should keep our nails dash. Now what is this dash? In this dash, we have to fill a correct word so that the sentence gives us a correct meaning. So, how should we keep them? Clean or dirty? Do you remember we had discussed this in the last class? Yes, correct. We should keep our nails clean. So, we will fill the blank with the word clean and then read the whole sentence again. Now kids, can you read the whole sentence? We should keep our nails clean. Now it gives us a correct meaning. So like this, we have to do fill in the blanks. I will share a few more examples with all of you and you can do that work in your notebook. Okay kids?
Now kids, as you can see on this page, few words are underlined. The words which are underlined were blanks and we have filled the correct word for all of you. So let us revise all the 4 points. The first one is we should comb our hair daily. In this, comb was not written and we have written comb and then the sentence is complete. In number 2, we should keep our nails clean. As you can see, clean has been underlined, so we had filled the word clean and now the sentence says we should keep our nails clean, which is correct. Number 3, exercise keeps our body fit. So we have written fit and the sentence is now complete. Children, I hope you have understood the concept of fill in the blanks, which I have explained you in the above 3 examples. Now, the last point is we should brush our teeth twice a day. Now in this, as you can see, twice has been underlined, so we have filled twice in this sentence and then it makes a complete sentence and also it is correct. We should brush our teeth twice a day.
I'm sure, kids, you all must have understood the concept of fill in the blanks. They were so easy, isn't it? We knew everything about the chapter because we all have done it so nicely. So kids, I will share a sample with all of you. You all can do that work in your notebook and complete it. Okay, children? Thank you so much. Hi kids, I'm back. I hope you all have understood fill in the blanks. And in this class, you all will do true and false with Monisha ma'am. Okay children, you must be wondering what is the meaning of true and false. By true and false, we mean that we have to write true in front of the sentence which is correct, and the sentence which is not correct, which is wrong, you have to write false. Okay kids, always remember two things. You have to write true in front of the sentence which is correct, and the sentence which is incorrect, you have to write false in front of that. Okay children, you will understand this with an example. Now kids, can you read the sentence which is written above? It is written, we should drink plenty of water. Now what do we mean with this? First, you have to read the sentence and understand it. The meaning of this sentence is that we should drink lots of water. So is it right or wrong? We should drink, right kids? We had discussed this in our earlier class that drinking lots of water is good for our health. Now we know that the above sentence is correct. Now if the sentence is correct, what I had told you, we will write true in front of the sentence. And if the sentence is incorrect, we will write false. I will give you two more examples of true and false to make it more clear and easy for all of you to understand.
So let's start. Number one, staying clean keeps our body healthy. Children, is it right or wrong? Staying clean keeps us healthy. Yes, so we will write true in front of that. Number two, we must not exercise daily. Kids, but we had discussed that we should exercise daily. So this is incorrect. So we will write false in front of that. Alright children. Now number three, we should drink plenty of water. This means that we should drink lot of water, which is correct. So we will write true in front of that. Children, I'm sharing a sample of the notebook work so that
you all can do this work in your notebook and share it with your teachers. Okay children, thank you so much for watching the video. I am sure you must have understood and also enjoyed it. I had lot of fun teaching all of you. Till we meet next time, stay home, stay safe, and happy learning, kids.